Okay, this is Rich again, and I was just talking to you about the void, and I was talking in a really respectful and reverent manner. And so now I got to, you talk like that for a little while. It takes a little bit to shake it off. Okay, so there's another way to talk about this whole subject. And it's not really different information. It's a different approach to sharing it. Now, this may or may not be a cuss-worthy experience. Now, some of my viewers don't cuss. They don't like cussing. They don't like the cuss word. And I think I'm going to have to do a whole video on cussing just to get so my viewers, you guys, know where I'm coming from when I use the F word and all that stuff. Okay, so what does that have to do with the void? Not much, okay? But what it does have to do with what the void is that, oh, first of all, if you didn't look at the other video first, we're talking about what the void is as far as doing a meditation and getting back in the touch with the oneness of the all that is and the nirvana place and that wonderful place in consciousness, which is void of any and everything except you and your awareness and conscious and knowingness, which is connected with God. And it has to be with God, because if it's not with God, it's separate from God. And if it's separate from, that means there's something there. There's something that's separate from something else. So that's something. So you can't get to the void if you're not at one with the all that is, the consciousness that is, you see. So the void in that way is consciousness. But if you go conscious with what? Who am I conscious? You know, what am I conscious? Nah, no, it's not about conscious of something. It's just conscious, okay? So, now, let's see. Excuse me. Getting over a cough thing. The trick about the void is that we can't stop talking. Now, the reason we can't stop talking in our heads, I'm talking about when you close your eyes and relax and you just want to not say anything. We are creators, okay? We create as in spirit. That's what we do. We create life. We create problems. We create solutions. We play these games. We're this person. We're that person. We're angelic beings. We're human beings. We separate ourselves out from the things we create. We just do all this stuff. And we're doers in that way. We're doers and we're thinkers. And so when we stop, when we close our eyes to relax and not do anything at all, that kind of goes against part of our nature. Now, not our true, most spiritual nature, but there's what we were, the all-powerful creative beings, or our consciousness, and in that place we created what we are now. We are the result of our considerations and decisions and intentions to be something other than what we were, so that we can now enjoy life and experience in a new and different way. And so what we've done is we've created ourselves into, you might say, compulsive creators. That's what we do. We create things. You know, if we don't create it with our hands in a pile of dirt and some wood, we're going to create it with our minds. And that's ultimately where we do all of our creation, is in consciousness with thought. So we are compulsive thinkers. That's what we do. And it's very unnatural for most people to stop thinking. Okay, so you go like this, and so we get this little subroutine of create. At least we can talk. We can talk a little bit. Talk about. And when you're talking, you're putting something into the void. Okay, so the void, what you are conscious of, is something. So you're not in the void. You haven't created yourself and got yourself into the void yet. Okay, so what you need to do is whatever meditation technique you want to try to use. So you can get to this quiet place. It's so quiet that you're getting back in touch with simply being aware that you are aware, being conscious that you are conscious. Not about something, because if you're conscious of something, then you've put something in the void, so it's no longer the void. And if imagine this for a minute. If there was like the void. And the void was deep and vast and empty of anything and everything except you. you're the one thing in that void, then there's one thing. And there's no other thing. So there's no other thing, and you can't fill a void because there's a something and everything else is nothing. So there's nothing to fill. Weird, huh? So if there's you, you're aware of you in the void, you're not in the void. You're aware of you, and you fill up the entire void to full, so it's no longer void, it's full, and it's full of you. And it might be just your awareness of self, and so awareness of self would be filling the void, so the void is not empty. So if you want to get to the empty voidness of it all, what you do, practice, and there are people that can do this a whole lot better than I can. You might want to talk to them and ask them, does Rich got it right? They'll probably go, nah, he's got it all wrong. Oh, tell us, great one, how it really is. And that's fine with me, because what do I know? So, here's the deal. If you can, you quiet the mind, one way or another, and you ultimately become aware of the knowing. And you become the knowing. You become the consciousness. The consciousness is the void. You become the void. And it's da. And within that void, I would imagine there's every possible potential for thought and creation in any universe, in any time. Just infinite in time and space potential. I'm not saying actuality or creation, but you're at that place of knowing or awareness of consciousness, and it's just got to be like a real rush. You know? It's like, whoa, wow. And so people say they're at one with God. It's just like, yeah, it's got to be at one with God, because the God is the all that is the all that is nothing more than pure, I would say, pure consciousness. Awake, aware, conscious. I think it's a step down to be conscious of self, because you've just created yourself as a something to be conscious of, and so you've got duality there. At least you've got a self separate from the all that is or the void. Okay, so that's my spin on that. And I didn't do my homework on that. I probably should have Googled it first, but I didn't. Okay, that's all I wanted to say. It's just another way of talking about this stuff, you know, and. I think personally everybody is going to either get this or not from a direct experience, and they're going to have their own personal experience with it, and they're going to share it, and there are many different ways that people will share, you know, hey, I experienced the one with God and the God consciousness and all that, and that is absolutely wonderful. And so your job is to do what it takes to get there yourself, so you will know. And then you can share it or not share it, whatever. So that's me on the void. Take two. Okay? Thanks for listening. Talk to you later. I think I'll do another video right after this about meditation types. Not that I'm the expert, but I do meditations. Okay. Talk to you later, buddies. Bye-bye.